I don't know how artists today work without having a knowledge of drawing. I just think it's the basis for everything. It's where everything begins. A lot of drawing I do outside in the landscape. I've got endless sketchbooks and diaries. I have to draw all the time. And it's through the drawing that the ideas come forward, and that, you know, and I think you can really tell an artist who's had some drawing ability, and you can certainly tell the ones who haven't, you know.
Drawing really initially is the bones, isn't it, of a painting.
Drawing in a sense is like an archive of the thinking, rather than drawing to make art per se. Yeah, it's much more about noting things down. Yeah.
You'd be surprised. I've got enough drawings from a model. If you could pulp them and turn them into bricks, you could build a two-bedroom home out of them. So they go nowhere. They're just things in themselves.
So yeah, I do a fair bit of preliminary drawing. I wouldn't just start a canvas not knowing what was going to happen. Although maybe I should.
I feel such a joy with paint that I really I just go straight to the finished painting with hardly a sketch.
I'm scrubbing out a lot more paintings than I did now 10 years ago, and going back to the drawing and starting again. I'm much better, I think, at editing than I was at the start, but I guess that's just a process that everybody goes through.
There's nothing that you can't do in drawing that you can do in painting. Painting for me was an exploration of atmosphere and colour. It just added another dimension to drawing.
Look, I think it's so important that an artist who can't draw has a limited future. It's as vital as that.